Okay, I just want to talk about fonts today. Now, you see, what this is the spreadsheet we were looking at in lesson 8, the previous lesson, and it's just a little bit too squished together. See, the numbers here are running off of the right side of the column, and here the names are kind of cut off so that you can't see the names, right? So whenever possible, when you're making an Excel spreadsheet that somebody's going to look at, you should set it up so that they can see everything in one page without having to move around like that or scroll up and down, right? So the first thing is we should look at the fonts, right? So if we look at, say, any empty cell here, it will tell you what the font is, and the font here is Calibri 11, right? Which is the default font. Now, the first thing is when you're dealing with any numbers, so see this whole area here, this rectangle here, when you're dealing with numbers, you should always have it in Courier font, right? Courier New font, right? Because the Courier New font is the font where every character is the same width, and that's what you want for numbers, because you want the decimal point to line up like this when you're adding a column of numbers. Now, because that means that all of the characters are wide, it takes up more space. So if you want everything to fit on the page, you might have to change to a smaller size, right? Like you might have to change to 10. See, I've changed to 10, it's still kind of too big. You might have to change to 8, right? So I've changed to 8. And we can adjust the width here now, right? So right now that rectangle is highlighted, so I'll just click on an empty cell to get rid of that highlight. And then I'll double click on the line here to make this column the width of the largest value. Same thing here, double click, same thing here, double click. And I'll have to scroll over here and I'll double click here, right? Then I'll go back. So now we're a little bit better anyways, right? Okay, so we've also got the dates in here, right? I'll show you what I mean about the font. Suppose I have a 1911 here, and I have 1999, 1231 here, right? Okay, it's not too obvious there, but see, because this is not a Courier New font here, the one is not the same width as, say, the 9. Right, it's actually probably not noticeable in this case, but just to be on the safe side, I'll change that to Courier New, right? C-O-U-R, Courier New, right? You see it's going to the hash mark because it's too big. I'll change that to 8, and it's still too big, right? And there, okay, so there it is. And it's also, when I did that, I clicked on column B, right? So it changed everything in column B. That's including the heading, which I didn't really want. If we look at this heading here, it's Calibri 11, right? So we should make birth date heading the same. And there's actually an icon here. It's called the Format Painter, right? So if I click here, see gross salary, then icon birth date. Then what it does is it makes birth date the same formatting as gross salary, right? Now the names are still being cut off here, right? So there's a number of things we could do about that. Actually, this column here we were just using for testing purposes. So we could it's not really relevant to the information, so we could change this to small font. This is the small font here, and then we could change it to size 4, right? or a size 5.5. And then I could double click on the line there and it makes it smaller, because we're not really interested for normal purposes in as to what's in that column, right? And then I can stretch out the name field there a little bit. So the name field is there, but you see it's still being cut off. So I can click on this area here. And I'll change the font here. See, now the first thing is I can change it to Arial Narrow, because Arial Narrow, the characters are narrow, so they take up less space, but they're still being cut off, right? So I can change it to a size 8, right? And now they're readable, right? Now I should also put a label here that says total. Because anytime you have any figure, especially in accounting, right? Anytime you have any figure, you should always have a label telling the user what that figure is, right? So this is the total. So I put in the total here, and in fact, to make it very clear that this is the total, I could drag through that whole area and make the background yellow, right? So now it's obvious anything that's yellow is a total. That's just kind of the part of computer interface design, right? Try to make everything as obvious as possible as to what it is, and to group things that are related together, right? Now another thing here is, you see these headings like tax, it's aligned on the left, because when you type anything in any column, then it's always, well, if it's text, it's aligned on the left, right? So for example, if I type Joe here, then Joe is aligned on the left, right? On the other hand, if I type a number, right, like $1.11, it's aligned on the right, right? That's what Excel does by default, right? If you want something different, you can change the alignment here. So for example, here with tax and net, say if I want it to be aligned on the right, I click here, see the, that's kind of like an icon of things being aligned on the right. So the same thing with gross salary, I could align that on the right. Birth date, I could align in the middle like this, right? This thing I can align on the right also. So now I'll take this, I'll do a Control C for copy, Control X for delete, then I'll click go up here, I'll do a Control V for insert. And Joe, I already got a Joe negative, right? So I can make this Joe positive. And I'll put in the, I'll move this up here too, right? Control C, Control X, Control V, right? Now, I'm getting an error there because it's not able to do the calculation properly. That's the kind of symbol that you get if it can't do a calculation properly, right? And it's saying I don't know what it is I'm supposed to divide by 3, right? So we can copy the formula from the cell above there, right? Like that, right? The same thing here, like this. And now it's possible for somebody to have a name that's going to go over the space there, right? Suppose we have somebody that has a middle name, like James Allen Duhan. Right, now you see it's being cut off there, right? I'll just put in $2 here. So you can do a number of things in that case, right? Like you could do the word wrap thing that we did before. So I could right click on this cell, format cells, go to alignment, click on wrap text, right? And you could do that. See, that makes that row twice as high as the other rows, which is kind of confusing. See, you could do this, right? It's up to you whether you want to do that or not. Actually, another thing you could do is like what I did before, right? Is to change that to smaller text, right? So I'll go down to small font. Right, and I'll change it to size 6, right? Okay, so there, the row is closer to the same size as the other rows, and you can still kind of read there that it says James Allen Doohan, right? You could even change this, I think, to Arial Narrow to be the same as the others, right? Like this, right? So it's up to you. Let's right now we've got it at a size 6. Let's try that's a size 8. Right? You can even see there is no 7 here. If you look, the 8 is the smallest number, but I can type a 7 in here, right? And then it will go to size 7, right? Or okay, I'm just going to change it back to 8 here, right? And what I'll do is, see, I could squeeze it in there like that, but it's being cut off, right? So there isn't any perfect solution in this kind of case. So it's kind of, you have to make a choice as to which way you want to do it. Okay, see, there for the heading, I could change this heading to a bigger size, right? I'll do that with the Format Painter thing again, right? So here's Net. I'll click on the Format Painter, right? Then I'll click on this, right? And so now it changes to be the same formatting as the previous cell, right? So that's the lesson today. The most important thing I wanted to point out is that numbers should always be in Courier New font, because that's the only font where you're guaranteed that these decimal points will line up to be not moved over to the left or right. So that's the lesson for today, and thanks for watching.